just how I remembered it, you know, when I was there 2 years ago, and then subsequently had my house raided by the FBI 2 months later, even though I didn't really, you know, break in or assault any officers. Ladies and gentlemen, what you're looking at right now is a live shot of our nation's capital. It's about 4 o'clock here on the Pacific Coast, 7 o'clock there. And in that building, just yesterday, I believe, was it yesterday or the day before, Speaker of the House McCarthy was booted. Thank the Lord. We also have to recognize, since we're talking about it, I'll get to the sunglasses here in a sec. We also have to recognize that this is also the site of the horrific events on January 6, 2021, when 65,000 Americans lost their lives in that building, according to CNN. And right on these steps, as you see, right over here on these steps, okay, you had AOC fighting off the terrorists. I don't know how she did that seven buildings away, but we gotta believe her, believe all women. Don't worry about it. Gotta stay with the program. Why the sunglasses, David? Is your future bright? Is America's future bright? Oh man, it depends on who you talk to. Okay, if you're talking to a Christian, of course it's bright. Because you have Jesus coming back, hopefully next week, with how everything's going. My gosh, how much are you guys paying for gas and groceries right now? Are you liking that? I mean, my gosh. Now, two reasons why I'm wearing the glasses. One, to pay homage to one of my favorite streamers, Dr. Disrespect, who gave the best advice when he was asked for content creators, what's your best advice? He said, quit. And that's what I did. I quit. And then I got fat, even fatter than I am now, and decided I didn't want to live that life. So here we are. What can you expect from this show? Oh, the other reason. There's lights everywhere in the studio. I don't know if you guys can see. You guys can't see it, but there's lights everywhere. It gives me a headache. I can't do it for 2 hours without the sunglasses. So I thought, hey, might as well pay tribute to my favorite streamer, who has inspired me. Doc, if you're watching ever, probably not, because you're a multi-billionaire. But what better way to pay homage to my favorite streamer and deal with the lights at the same time? Because there'd be times in the past where I was streaming, couldn't handle the lights, had to end the stream. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna go as long as we want. So what can you expect from this show? I'm gonna be as real as possible. I'm not trying to self-censor. I'm not trying to hurt anybody. I'm not trying to do anything except be myself. But I wanted to start my very first show off in front of this sacred ground right here, where all of our problems lie. That's not a threat, FBI. I know you're watching. I'm also not here, FBI. This is a green screen, okay? I know you're already putting people on lists. I know I already probably made it, but I'm not actually there, okay? I'm going to get a pass next time I decide to go into that place, okay? I could learn my lesson the hard way. Folks, listen. A lot of you are stressed, right? You watch other shows. You hear the news. It's always bad news. We're going to talk about that goofy stuff, too. But we're going to have a good time. That's what you can expect from the show. We're going to be real. And we're going to go as long as I can, as long as my migraines allow me to. And I know some of you are here for this right here. Okay, giving these away. Ship anywhere in the U.S. All you got to pay is $795 to have it shipped. No, I'm just kidding. It's free shipping. We're going to give this away, free AirPods. I'm sorry they're not the AirPods Pro. Okay, I'm not a multimillionaire. I don't have the Daily Wire budget, okay? But we're going to give those away, second generation AirPods. Folks, you might wonder why there's circus music playing in the background. It's still playing, I don't even know. But that's exactly what this building represents, as a circus. How much money are we going to give to Ukraine? How much money are we going to give to Ukraine's borders and not our borders, you know? And all those amazing decisions come from this building right here. And if you don't know politics, you don't understand politics, that's okay. We're here to also educate. We'll inform you, okay? I've worked in politics for 4 or 5 years. Used to work for a Trump advisor, okay? I know my way around this game, and we're going to navigate it together. If you feel dumb, if you feel like, oh, what does Speaker of the House mean if it's removed? Don't feel dumb. Don't feel dumb, okay? Because we're not here to look down on you unless you think kids can change their gender. But that's another story. Hey, we're going to talk about that too. There's a footage out of that Hazelbrook girl that got attacked, and there's a longer version of it that I never saw until a few days ago. I'm going to show that. I'm going to play that. Folks, buckle up. We're going to keep an eye on the Capitol here. Again, FBI, calm down. We're going to keep an eye on the Capitol. We're going to have some fun. I'm having a great time already. Let's get going. Buckle up. What do you guys think of the new studio, huh? It's pretty nice, huh? It was bought by 5 bags of cans that we had to return on top of selling a couple mattresses in the house, and now we got a beautiful studio. Hey, I want to start off real quick before I forget, because I know I'm going to forget these two things. One, you can call into the show. I'm going to go live as long as I feel like it. I mean, this is fun for me. This ain't work. I'm going to go live. We're going to be doing a bunch of things. We're going to be looking on Twitter. One of the things we're going to do is we're going to look on Twitter, and we're going to see, you know, what's going on the Twitter feed. We're going to see what's going on in the Instagram reels, and we're going to look at those. We're going to react to those together. It's going to be fun. Call into the show, 971-447-2555. I did not choose that number. T-Mobile did. It's not a plug for T-Mobile. Folks, it's good to see you. It's good to see you. Sorry for the sunglasses. There's just no other way. I'm sorry. These lights kill me. I mean, I don't know if you're a studio expert out there, there's contacts that they sell to help my eyes. But also, I like paying tribute to my boy, Dr. Disrespect. That's my boy. The best content creator out there. He's my inspiration. But hey, let's see that video real quick. Here, check this out. Let's look at this video of the girl getting attacked. This is a longer video. Check this out. Okay, so you guys heard about the Hazelbrook girl getting attacked in Oregon, Hazelbrook Middle School. It's in Tualatin, Oregon. There was a viral video of a transgender kid that pulled the girl down by her backpack and then started beating her and said some cuss words and whatever. I don't know. Vote Biden in 2024. I don't know what the kid said, but the kid yelled something at the girl, the poor girl. We had her mom, the girl's mom, in studio, interviewed her for a podcast. Haven't released that yet because attorneys that make oh my gosh, why is my mic so loud? There we go. Oh my gosh, you guys are probably like, what is this guy doing? There we go. The mic should sound better. I'm like looking at my levels and it's like this right now on my editing screen. And so let's turn that down there. That's better. So the mom was in the studio. We talked to her, about how she felt. And we released a clip. You can go see that on David Medina, OFA, and OFA Media Org on Instagram and Facebook. But anyways, the girl got attacked, and the mom and her husband, who's not the kid's father, it's the kid's stepdad, the mom has this kid with her previous boyfriend. They have joint custody. Anyways, so she's like, no, there's a longer video out. And I was like, why hasn't that been going around? Because you see how even more premeditated this attack was. So Let's play that real quick. Let's get going on. Let's see. Display. All right, you guys see my computer? Look at all my apps. You can take a picture if you like. See all the apps I use for everything I do. Okay, so the video was, let's go to downloads. My eyes already feel great. I absolutely love these glasses. I already feel good, feel even. You should see, like, when I'm trying to do lives in the past, I'm like squinting. It's like started to get a migraine around the 50 minute mark. Okay, check this out. Wait, is that, nope, that's a still photo. It's good stuff, David. Keep it up. It's a good start to the show. All right, right here. Is this it? Oh, yeah. Nope, not it. Okay. This is it. I promise this is it. What? She hasn't even came to the door yet.
How do you know?
There she is right there.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, man. I'm gonna play, I know that's hard to watch, but I'm gonna play it back real quick. This has to sink in how bad this is. Imagine if this was your kid, if this was your daughter. And so the thing is like, this kid has done this to other girls at the school and nothing has been done about it. Nothing was done about it last year. And this same kid attacked, did you see how premeditated it was? There's already people recording before this girl even walked through the door. This is the direction that our schools are headed in America, guys. This is already here in Oregon. It's despicable. Call into the show, 971-447-2555. I want to know people's reactions to McCarthy being removed. What do you guys think the path is forward for America? You know, that was crazy. I mean, I think that's the first time in history a speaker has been removed. And then you saw Mitch McConnell afterwards. He was like, let's see if we can find it. Mitch McConnell said, hey, we need to get rid of that motion to vacate. And he's just so pathetic. The whole old Republican Party is. I can't wait to go through these. Okay, come on, dude. Can't wait to go through these Twitter feeds right now, because look at the first story. It's gotten worse. People react to Monday's mass overdose incident in Portland. You know, if this was Republicans in charge of Portland, do you realize what would be the story? Is like Republicans' policies continue to fail. But these guys, you know, we already talked about it. We've already discussed it. They're the arm of the Democrat Party in Oregon, and it's disgusting. I forgot what I was going to say. See, this whole show is unscripted, by the way. We're just going with the flow. This is what I usually do during the day, and so I'm just putting it to the stream. You know, we might play a video game or two later. If you don't like video games, figure out your life. There's nothing wrong with it. Video game champion right here. Let's see here. What were we going to do? Someone in the chat, help me. And I haven't found a way to go live on X, by the way, from this system. Let's see. Oh, my gosh. We were looking at the video. Were we going to play go follow me on X if you guys haven't yet. We are giving away these AirPods tonight to one lucky listener, whoever calls in, or it could be someone that called in. That might increase your chances. It could be someone in the chat. It could just be someone I just randomly think of. I don't know. You guys can figure out. Okay, here's the clip of the mom.
He has her face at the end.
This was a hard interview, man. How many times have you watched that?
I really can't stomach watching it very much. It's emotional.
Oh.
Yeah, just to see. I think what gets me is her face at the end. Like, she's mortified. Absolutely just doesn't know what
she did
wrong.
I'm trying to hold it together. I'm trying not to, like,
and
break down and cry.
I was furious.
During this.
You know, and as a parent, I think anybody who sees their child like that is animalistic. We want to protect our children.
So you feel let down by the school district?
Yes, I do, because this child that attacked my daughter has a record of attacking other students, in particular girls. And there is another video circulating of him attacking two other girls.
Yeah.
So there's clearly a pattern.
Well, folks, I told you this is going to be as organic as possible. And right now we have We have a someone calling me on my personal phone. I think this is a car dealership. Let's take the call. Hello, this is David.
Hey, David, it's Alan from where I'm talking. How are you doing today?
Hey, Alan. Good. You know, I just, you know, enjoy your 19 emails a day that I get. Shows that you're doing your job.
I was just checking in with you. I mean, I haven't really been able to hear back from you since we, you know, first had that conversation. I know you talked with Adam.
Yeah.
Are you still on the hunt for a vehicle, or are you able to find something already?
You know, I almost got a Tesla. What do you think of Teslas, Alan? This is Alan from Ron Talkin'. Alan, you're live right now on a show on YouTube.
Okay.
No, I mean, this wasn't, Alan, I didn't know you were calling. I'm just taking whatever, anybody that calls me on my show number or my personal number, I'm just taking calls and I'm just going to play it how it was. So anyways, let's talk about it. I mean, this is how you get the plug out because, I mean, I had a bad experience at your dealership, but you guys were really good. You and your manager, I think his name is Jack, right?
Jake was the one that you chatted with, yes.
Yeah, Jake. Yeah, you and him were awesome, and it was really unfortunate that one salesman had to ruin it for you guys because I was there to buy that Jeep that day. You know what I mean?
Thank you for those comments. I mean, I wish the scenario was different when you were in store.
Right, me too. Did you guys fire that guy?
Can't really say per se if that was not the reason why, but he was let go.
So you guys let him go, but what was the reason if that wasn't the reason?
They never told us, they just told him that he was let go.
Right. Well, I'll just tell you this, Alan. I am still on the hunt for a new car. I was leaning Tesla, but then I've seen too many like Biden Harris stickers on the cars around here in Portland, and I just couldn't do it. It feels like almost everybody that has a Tesla, and I'm not saying everybody. There's probably people that don't like them that still have Teslas, but I just feel like they're for a certain demographic of people, and I also worry about the longevity of the battery. You know, because Teslas can't. You know, talk to me. What do you think about Teslas? Do you guys sell Teslas?
We do get a few of them in on trade every once in a while, but they're typically the people that are looking for or realizing that the electric side was great and all for those short commutes in town, but when they wanted to do something, you know, longer road trips with their families, it was not the ideal car.
Got it. Well, yes. Well, sir, to answer your question, and I don't want to keep you too long, I am still on the hunt for a new car. Do you guys still have that Jeep Compass? That I really like that because it gives me room when I want to go camping or I'm trying to get back into fishing. We have some good, you know, I used to fish a lot until, you know, I got married. I'm divorced now, but I got married and those rights were taken from me. So when I, do you guys still have that car I was looking at?
I know we have multiple of that, those 18 compasses that were on the lot. I think you were originally asking us about the white one, correct?
No, I think it was black.
It was black?
Yeah, it was black.
Go ahead and I will take another look through and see what I have for used compasses because I know those were all ones that we had purchased out of our service department.
Right.
So we got kind of a nice large chunk of them all coming at the same time, but I will take a look and see what we have and I'll get back to you, all right?
Sounds good, man. Hey, I thank you. I appreciate your customer service and sorry that that had to go that way when I first came to the dealership. I don't know why I get put in these situations, you know, when people like to pop off, but maybe they just, you know, I don't know. I can't tell you, but Alan, I appreciate you at Ron Talkin' over there in, where are you at? Milwaukee, Oregon?
Milwaukee, Oregon.
God bless you, man. Sorry to put you on the show, but you know, anything goes, anything that happens, any call I get, I don't care if it's from an ex-girlfriend, we're answering it. And so I appreciate you being a good sport, buddy.
All right.
Take care, man. Bye-bye. So we have a caller coming in right now. Let's take that call. I'm going to tell you guys about that story about when I went to go shop for a car. The most unbelievable story that it's ever happened to me anywhere customer service wise. And this happened at a dealership nearby. Let's take a call right now. Caller's coming in from Oregon. I don't know how to answer this because it's an Android. You're on the line. Say your name and where you're from.
My name is Sue Smith. And Sue, I'm originally Smith. From Tigard, Oregon. And right now I live in Arizona.
Sue, what do you want to say?
Well, I just want to say that what's going on at the Hazelbrook Middle School is a travesty for the Tigard-Tualatin School District.
It's a travesty for Americans everywhere.
Travesty for Americans everywhere. I'm a former teacher in the district. I just got off the phone with a teacher who said that Steepes Elementary School and things are blowing up at the schools. Kids are out of control.
So you were a teacher in the Tigard-Tualatin School District for
21 years.
For 21 years,
21.
And why did you quit?
Well, the reason I quit was COVID. They were going to require me to wear a K95 mask from the, I think it was October 18th, that infamous year. And I had started school in August and didn't have to wear a K-19 mask.
So they're trying to get you to mask up and you didn't want to mask up.
No. And I taught physical education and I was told, even though, you know, I started school in August, I sat with my team members, the other PE teacher and the music teacher at lunch. I was told I couldn't be around anybody with my mask off. So I couldn't.
Yeah, because they were
so
effective,
eat
right?
With my peers.
You want to know, Sue? You want to know something? This isn't very Christian of me, but I made an observation today. I was at the grocery store. I almost tweeted it out, but I was like, this kind of sounds mean, but I'm going to say it. I was at the grocery store today, and I noticed four people with masks on, and every single one of them were morbidly obese. And and I don't have a problem with people, you know, like, I mean, come on, I mean, I'm not in the best shape. I mean, look at me. I'm trying. But I thought to myself, do we care about our health or not? Why are you wearing a mask, but you're literally at least a couple hundred pounds overweight? So it's like, it makes me wonder where these people's heads are. But you used to be a teacher with the school district, and you got pushed out because you wouldn't mask. And so, where are you from? Where are you living right now?
Maricopa, Arizona.
Maricopa, Arizona.
And so, not very many people around here are wearing masks.
Yeah.
And we got here last November. Not very many people were wearing masks, but I did visit Oregon last week. And it was crazy how many people had masks on. There was a distinct difference. And, you know, you go to Trader Joe's in King City, and I was about ready to go up to the store manager and ask him if people were sick in the store because so many of their employees had masks on. It made me feel uncomfortable.
Yeah. No, I feel you. Sue, thanks for the call, and God bless you. Thank you for being a teacher all those years. I'm really sorry your country failed you and that your community failed you. It should have never happened, but keep your head on straight. We thank you so much. You're a big-time supporter of what we
thank
do
you.
Here, and call anytime, okay?
All right. Talk to you later.
God bless.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sue Smith, used to be a teacher, called in. See, this show can just go anywhere, and we're just going to go with it. I mean, we got a call from a dealership trying to sell me a car for like the thousandth time this week. We got Sue Smith calling. We just got a bunch of stuff going on. We're just going to roll with it. We got another one. We got a Benjamin Hitz. Should we answer it? Let's answer it real quick. I like that you guys are calling in. This is awesome. You're on the show, Benjamin.
Yep.
How you doing? Where are you from?
Where's the town from?
Where are you from?
I want to see if my VPN is working. Where does it say I'm from?
It says Oregon. So what part of Oregon are you from?
I'm from Tigard.
Okay, so just down the road. So what's up, man? What do you want to say?
Oh, I was just following this whole Hazelbrook school thing, and I had kids that went to school in that area, not to that exact school. They went to Tualatin, but I remember none of this kind of stuff happening when they were younger, and just it's really sad to see it spreading everywhere.
When they were younger, what do you mean, like 10 years ago,
so
20 years ago?
They're grown now. Yeah, even 10 years ago.
Yeah. No, school is very, very different when I went to school. I grew up in the 90s and the 2000s. I'm a millennial. And it very, very different from the environment. I mean, you would go to detention if you said, damn or hell. I mean, you just, you know, and now these kids, we can just do whatever we want. We can identify as a magical unicorn. We can, we can hit people, hit kids, and we won't get expelled. And it's just, it's so disgusting, man. So what do you, let me tell you that, Ben, what are your thoughts? What went through your head as a parent when you saw that video?
I honestly felt sick to my stomach. I mean, this whole idea of letting kids lead and make life-changing adult decisions, allowing that door to even open has created a snowball effect that is making all of this madness so much more apparent, and it's spreading everywhere, younger and younger. I remember when this kind of stuff only happened on college campus, and I'm just waiting for the elementary schools to start reporting about it.
Yeah, I feel you, man. Well, hey, man, thanks for the call. Call anytime, and, you know, just keep the faith, man. I you know, you live about 15, 20 minutes from me. And let me just tell you something. I feel like going crazy every single day here. But are you a Christian?
Yes, sir.
There you go. You got it figured out. All right, sir. Thank you for the call. Call back anytime, okay?
Will do. God bless.
There you go. There's Benjamin from Tigard, Oregon. Man, I love that you guys are already calling in, man. I didn't even expect that. Right away, at least. This is awesome. Who else is going to call? Let me get us going live on OFA Media's Instagram real quick. Let me get us going here real quick. Hold on. Let me put on a... Let's go back to the Capitol real quick while I'm doing this. Kind of sounds like Disneyland a little bit. Make you want to go to Disneyland? Satanland? All right, there we go. All right, enough of that. We're live on YouTube. Now we're live on OFA Media. Call in. Couple of great calls already, man. We have people wanting to talk about the Hazelbrook incident. We have the full interview with the mom. That's yet to be released. We're supposed to release it yesterday, and then the big old attorneys came in and said, "Hey, you know, let's just calm down," and which is fine. It's all listen. I'm not an attorney; they are, and so we're gonna trust them. We don't want to cause the family any more stress. It's a wonderful family, by the way, wonderful family. It's so sad that our kids are being attacked like their kid got attacked. I have a 15-year-old daughter, and I know you're like, David, hey, you look like you're 19. I get it. Thank you. I appreciate that. But here's the thing: is like, if that were my daughter, I'd be in jail right now. And I'm not just saying that. Like, I would be throwing chairs at the school if that happened to my daughter from the same kid who's done this before to other girls. And no one, what happened? Why was he able to go back to school and do this again and terrorize another girl? So anyways, hey, OFA Media on Instagram, you guys come join us. We're having fun here. We're taking calls. We're talking about this issue with Hazelbrook. We're talking about Trump possibly being Speaker of the House. We're talking, what else are we doing here, guys? I mean, I don't even know what we're doing. It's so, we took a call from a dealership. Let me tell you about the dealership, the dealership story real quick. So I went to go buy a car. So as you all know, I'm in the market for a car. So if you're a car salesman, call in, pitch me why I should buy from you. But I went to a dealership over right outside of Portland. It was a Wrong Talking dealership of Milwaukee. Got a phone call, a very important work phone call, right as I was parking. So I parked, right? And this dude, Les Schwab, like Mr. Les Schwab, runs out. He didn't really run out, but he came out. He rushed me. And he's like, you know, he's just doing his job, right? And I was like, hey, I'm on the phone. I'm on my AirPods, right? By the way, giving away AirPods tonight. I was on my AirPods. I showed him. I was like, hey, I'm on my AirPods. You know, don't bother me. You just give me a second. You know, just trying to be really nice, right? This dude stays at my car, hovers over me, and like I'm feeling like pressure. I'm feeling him like breathing down my neck. And so he's like this, and I kind of look over as I'm still on the phone. He can clearly see I'm on a work call. He puts his hands up like this. And I'm just like, I'm like, hey man, can you hold on for one sec? Took out my AirPod. I was like, hey sir, I'm here on an appointment to buy a car. I'm on a work phone call. I'm coming in, I promise. Can you just give me just a second? And before I could even finish that sentence, this car salesman at Ron Tonkin in Milwaukee, Oregon, cuts me off and goes like this and walks away. I go, oh, okay, all right. I'm here to give you business. That's how you're going to treat me, just because I'm not on your time. Sorry, guy. He was like some 54-year-old, just old timer, which is fine. We love old timers. No hate against his age group. I'm not ageist. I'm not an ageist. But I went inside And I was like, hey, man, I told my salesman that I was there to see. I said, hey, I don't really appreciate this guy's attitude and the way he hovered over me. I'm here to like spend a couple, few grand, 20 grand, right? And why is he giving me that attitude? And this guy comes over, I kid you not, I'm standing there with my salesman, who's a very nice guy, Alan Drake. You just heard him on the phone. And if you were on YouTube, Instagram, you would have heard it. But this guy comes over. He goes, now you're just lying through your teeth. He goes, I didn't do any of that. I go, bro, go check the cameras. It was just a big mess. And I go, I just cannot believe we're in 2023. The economy is the way it is because we have a freaking mummy in the White House. Everything costs a lot. I know you guys are having trouble moving cars. And this was my first impression of you guys. I couldn't believe it. So I was like, I got to go, man, because I'm at this point, I'm pissed off. And I just, I can't focus right now. And I can't make a big decision right now. So this is going to have to wait. So I walked out. Their manager ran out to the car, apologized. I said, you can't have that. You can't have that, man. That guy just cost your boy a sale. You can't have that these days. If you're a salesman, oh my gosh, that might be a nightmare story for you. I mean, we'd be throwing fists if I was that kid. I'd be throwing fists with that guy. Like, dude, you just blew a sale for me. Like the dude couldn't, anyways. So we had a call, Instagram, for those of you joining on Instagram, we had a call on, we just had a random call on the stream and I took it and there was Alan Drank. It was this guy trying to see if I was still interested in a car. I get like 90 of his emails a day. Anyways, 971-447-2555 if you want to call in. I forgot like what I was going to do, chat. I mean, can you guys tell me, help remind me what I came on here for before we got the call from Alan Drake and the other two callers. Anyways, let's react to some reels real quick. Hold on.
Come on. You want it just as much as I want it. And it's not wrong to want it.
I'm just going to tell you right now, disclaimer, that some of the craziest, I'm going to try to keep it clean. If it gets too crude, I'm going to skip on because I don't want you to get, you know, I don't want emails of like, why did you let your kid? Why did you show this to my, listen, this isn't my content. This is random reels on Instagram. Okay. And we're just looking through them real quick because I need a little breather. I'm going to go get a Coke Zero here in a sec because I'm starting to have dry mouth. And no, I'm not on cocaine or meth or anything. You know, I'm not part of the Biden family. I am here. So don't blame me, parents. Don't blame me. Okay. So this reel, right? This is pretty funny. Let's move on.
Mm-hmm. I'm proud of you. You know that. I hope you do. Mm-hmm. I'm proud of
my
you.
Toaster,
you know that.
Every time I use it.
I hope you do.
To make toast and not take a bath. That's so Mormon.
Proverbs 31:10.
That's so Mormon.
A good woman is hard to find and worth far more than diamonds.
Hard to find. Oh,
man, this is your sign to stop settling. Your wife is not at the clubs partying right now, so Amen. Don't waste your time there.
Amen.
The one for you is in her secret place with the Lord asking about you. Trust in the Lord.
I promise you
be
this
patient,
is not pre-planned.
And he will bring her to you.
That is beautiful. That is beautiful. And that could be for women too, because we want to be equal here. That could be for women too. So your man is somewhere. He ain't out, you know, at the strip clubs. He ain't out, you know, doing crazy things. He's going to church every Sunday. Your man's going to church Wednesdays. Gosh, the dating apps, man. Talking about, like, I've been divorced for over a year now. And let me tell you something. The dating apps, oh my goodness. Especially being 34. I'm 34 years old. And let me just tell you something. The dating apps, especially, I don't know if it's just Portland or what. What are we doing? I mean, I was on, I don't have them anymore. I deleted all of them because I'm just, it's a waste of time. And I feel like God's going to bring me my wife when I least expect it. That's usually how it happens. And this time I will do a better job. but let me just tell you something. These apps, man, it's like every, and guys, just correct, like talk to me here, man. Call in if you want. We could talk about this because I need to know guys, especially guys my age. Every other girl on these apps is like, has like 12 kids and is like divorced twice. Or, you know, and it's just like, God bless them. God bless you. No judgment. But like, I don't want to have 12 kids right now. I already have one. I could barely handle her. Can't even handle her. She's a great kid though. But my gosh. And then the other ones are like blue haired. Some of them aren't even women. Right, because I'm right outside of Portland. Shocker. But some of them are like are super like blue haired, and I'm not even kidding. Shaved, you know those ones that have the hair up top, and they, it's like all shaved up. They like shave their head, and then they leave just the top on. Looks like they have like a cap on. I don't know why they do that. But yeah, girls like that, girls that like, I just, man, like, where are the godly women at? Where are the godly women at? Where are the women at that can be the future mother of my future children? Can't be the mother of this 15-year-old because that's a more complicated situation. But oh my gosh, this reel right here, let's watch this again. This is why I love this part. We're going to do this all the time. This is awesome. Okay, go ahead and pause it.
Proverbs 31:10. A good woman is hard to find and worth far more than diamonds. Men, this is your sign to stop settling. Your wife is not at the clubs partying right now, so don't waste your time there. The one for you is in her secret place with the Lord, asking about you. Trust in the Lord.
Oh my gosh.
Be patient.
That's amazing.
And he will bring her to you.
I needed to hear that. All right, let's go to Raymond. He's calling from Oregon. Raymond, what part of Oregon are you from?
I'm from Eastern Oregon, Hermiston.
Oh yeah, yeah, Hermiston. That's like what is that, like 4 hours from Portland?
Three. Yeah, the more conservative area, or what used to be, you might say.
Okay. What's on your mind, man?
I just wanted to talk to you and think I love your material and everything like that, and your everything you share and everything like that. Kind of inspires me to look at things outside the box. I was in the military for 13 years, got out right when COVID hit. While you're in the military, you don't really listen to the government much, really. You're kind of like, well, I'm in it, so I'm just going to be told what to do a little bit. Got out, and things kind of like opened my mind. Like, it was a bigger box and everything like that. Came back to Eastern Oregon, and everything just changed, like, dramatically. Grew up with, normal country roots, hardworking, do what you can, and you'll make it, basically. No, I love your content, and I love where you're going with your podcast.
Hey, man, I really appreciate it, Raymond. You're from Hermiston, Oregon, talking to Raymond here. Dude, I appreciate it, man. That means so much to me. And thank you so much for your service in the military for 13 years. That's amazing, man. We appreciate our veterans here. We don't look down upon them. I've worked with veterans. I've worked with veterans with PTSD. That's no joke. Were you in any, were you deployed at all?
Yeah, I did 13 years. I did, 4 years in Lemoore at Iraq Squadron fighter jets. And then, I went to Fort Worth, Texas for some munitions, and then I went to Whidbey Island, Washington, where I went to sea duty, and I was deployed to Hawaii, Guam, South Korea, Japan. I lived in Japan my last 2 years in the Navy. I've seen Thailand, Australia. We were supposed to pull into Papua New Guinea, but they have actual indigenous people that will put your head on a stake if you go into their territory. They're a tribe still.
Yeah.
So
did you say you flew fighter? You're a pilot?
No, I was ordnance. I did the bombs, missiles, rockets, and guns on the fighters. So aircraft carriers. And
you had some experience. You had some time in Iraq. That's crazy, man.
No, not Iraq.
I'm sorry. I just completely. I have ADD. Just to let you know, Raymond. Sometimes, so like, I am listening to you, but I'm not grasping everything because I like honestly, if there was a squirrel in here, I'd be like off. So no disrespect. But like, remind me again what you did in the service.
I was an ordnanceman, bombs, missiles, rockets, and guns on jets. If the fighter pilots need it, we put it on there. They hit the catapult, take off, they're gone. My last tour was with helos and stuff like that. It was pretty interesting. It was a good experience to help me grow up and become a leader.
That's awesome, man. Well, hey, man, I appreciate the call. I appreciate your service. Let me get your name real quick because I'm actually going to put you as a contender for the AirPods. We're giving away AirPods today, and if you don't want them, you can give them to someone else. But let me get you on there. We're gonna do a drawing. I mean, you're a veteran. You go to the front of the line, man. I appreciate you. Thanks for the call. Real quick. Are you do you have a family? Do you have kids?
I do. I actually was watching your Tinder thing and. Me and my girlfriend, we've known each other since like sixth grade, and I came back, and then we just kind of rekindle things. It wasn't on Tinder or anything, but it was like on Snapchat. And
yeah, don't go on Tinder, man.
No. So I have a 12-year-old and a 14-year-old girl. So
God bless you.
Like the content you really share, and try to protect these kids from, you know, these people that want to be something they're not, and it becomes dangerous. Like that interview you had.
You cut out. What did you say about the interview? Did we lose him? We lost him. Raymond, you there? That was Raymond from Hermiston, Oregon. What a guy. Definitely a contender for the AirPods. I'm writing down names. I'm writing down a couple names here in the Instagram chat. I know it's hard to watch it through there. This is not to gain a viewership on here. This is just to tell you guys to go to YouTube. But we're giving away AirPods tonight. Raymond, you're definitely on the list. As one of, actually, let me make a reminder to call back Alan from Ron Tonkin. And I should do this more often, man. I'm not a type A person. I just go with the flow. You know, I don't like planning, but I'm gonna be a planner here real quick. I'm gonna write down Alan's name from Ron Tonkin, because this dude has emailed me like a record number of times, like Guinness Book of World Records. He's called me every single day asking me to buy from him. And he deserves a callback. So call back Raymond, or I'll call back Alan from Ron Tonkin, Milwaukee. Okay. We're looking for a new car. We're not getting a Tesla. Don't worry. Calm down. There are so many of you. Don't get a Tesla, David. Oh, my gosh. Don't get a Tesla. Raymond, thank you for your service. Man, he mentioned Tinder, by the way, since we're talking about dating apps. Tinder was one of the worst apps. Just low quality. I'm talking guys and girls. Like, the horror stories I've heard from girls about Tinder and about the things they've gone through on there. Oh, my gosh, man. Anyways. All right, let's get back. Let's go. Let's look at a couple more reels. That was a good one, man. Let's go back to the reels real quick. I got to remember to. Okay. Oh, no.
Guiding others to a treasure I cannot possess. Guiding others to a treasure I cannot possess. Guiding others to a treasure I cannot.
Oh, when you're too ugly to get a girlfriend, but you give good relationship advice. I mean, holy crap, story of my life. And then here's Draymond.
So, no, I'm not shooting it. Like, right. I am open. I probably should shoot it, but I'm not confident in it. So, should I shoot it if I'm not confident in the shot?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so. I'm not confident in the shot. So, no, I'm not shooting it. Like,
right.
I am open.
Okay. No big deal.
Why is this all relationships?
Not afraid to be alone with my thoughts. My thoughts are awesome. Die Hard 6 on a cruise ship, pizza bagel restaurant. My father never left me, and I'm gonna die alone. Oh boy, that happened fast. Guard!
Okay. Why is this all relationship stuff? What is Instagram trying to tell me right now? This is like, I feel attacked.
Off for him. It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off.
When your homie is about to tell his church crush, God told me you are going to be my wife.
It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for him.
That's from the movie Dodgeball.
It's a bold strategy.
That's a great movie. Let's see here. Dinner at Jake Jenkin in Portland, Oregon. Hey, Jenkin. Give your boy a sponsor.
See, this is what's wrong with men in America now. You're never supposed to let the woman walk on the outside next to the cars. Exactly. Chivalry is dead.
That's so sweet.
Unless you're trying to get divorced and you don't want to split up. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. I'm not advocating for that. But yeah, dude, what is this guy doing? I mean, this is probably Portland or Seattle. Why are you walking on the inside of the sidewalk while your girl's on the outside? If a car were to come, maybe he's got a plan. Maybe he is about to get divorced. I don't know. But yeah, don't ever let your girl walk on the outside next to the street. You always put her on the inside. Okay, relationships 101.
4% growth, double it.
You got it.
Double.
Done.
I'm not kidding.
Neither am I. It's already done.
I'm just kidding. It's gonna take some time.
Double.
That's awesome.
Show
these
me
memes are fire. I like that these are all memes. I didn't even know what to expect on this.
No. Listen to me. You want to go with timeout right here?
Hey, let me know if these sound from the reels are coming in too hot. If it's too loud, let me know. I'm going to try to turn that down a little bit. Sounds loud in my ear.
No. Listen to me.
Oh, my gosh.
You want to go with timeout right here?
Pick the little mijo up and give him a spanking. I mean, guys, if you're parents out there, you can still spank your children, okay? Don't go overboard where you're abusing and like leaving like marks and stuff. But if you're like, spank your children. The Bible says to spank our children,
okay? Do not spare your son the rod or you hate him, is what the Bible says. Here's your preaching sermon for the day. The world is coming to an end. What? See what I mean? Like, guys, I'm sorry you had to see that. Like, this is... This is the gamble of looking at random reels. You have something like that. If the world's ending, don't do that. Get on your knees next to your bed and make sure you say a prayer. Make sure you're saved. Make sure that we're going to move on. Goodness gracious.
Right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you something.
We don't care.
I'm here to tell you right now.
I love these Christian memes. These are getting so good.
Let me tell you something.
We don't care.
I'm going to follow
him. I'm here to tell you right now.
Let's check this account out real quick. Should we follow it? No, he's not a... He doesn't... Well, geez. Gosh, man. Let's get it together. What are we doing?
Dang it. I'm free.
All right, that's
I'm
enough
free.
Reels for now. Oh, man. Got a follow from Robbie Starbuck today on X. Maybe is pretty psyched about that. Hey, listen, we're going to say goodbye to the people on Instagram. Go to YouTube if you want to watch the show. Call in. We're taking calls about anything, relationships, politics, faith, whatever you want to talk about, whatever's on your mind. If you're struggling right now and you have anxiety, depression, if you're worried about something, just call in. Let's talk about it, man. You don't always have to, you know, call in and make a statement. You can call in and say, hey, I need help with this. And we'll talk it over together. Give us a call. Going live off of OFA Media on Instagram. Having a good time, man. This is fun. It's so fun when you just let things come naturally, you know, and I just it's so much less stressful. It's like I can talk. Let's go back to the Capitol. I gotta go get a Coke Zero because my mouth's starting to stick together like I'm on freaking crack or something. Okay, let's go back to the Capitol. Let's see how dark it got there.
Oh, man. Man, it's what time is it right now in D.C.? It's about 4:50 here. Siri, I wasn't talking to you! It's about 7:50 in D.C. And right about now, all the parasites are starting to leave the building. Probably got nothing done today, like always. Probably gave more money to Ukraine. I haven't really checked the news cycle today. Maybe we can check it together. But, man... I kind of want to go back there. Like, I wonder if they would let me. I don't know if they have me on a list or whatever, because I don't know if you know this about me, but my house got raided by the FBI. I was actually here on January 6th, came late, walked into Open Doors to get some video and yell freedom a couple times. And yeah, I just walked around. Everything was great. I mean, it wasn't, didn't think I was doing anything too wrong. I mean, I didn't see any of the violence initially, but anyways. House got raided 2 months later in March of 2021. I'll tell that story real quick. I was on a plane from Orlando to Portland, and when I landed in Portland, I got a phone call from my then wife who said, David, don't freak out as I'm on the plane, literally landing. I'm still in my seat. David, don't freak out. She was so good about this too. She's like, The FBI has raided the house. Your brother was put in cuffs or zip ties or whatever. He was detained. My brother, Jason, was here watching over the house while we were on our trip. And they tried to question Savannah, and our friend at the time, attorney, came over and took her out of the situation, which they drew guns on him when he pulled up. He came in like Dukes of Hazzards, I guess. Came in and just was like, I'm family attorney. I guess they all pulled guns on him, told him to put his hands up. It was crazy. Anyways. I know you're like, why are you drinking Woca-Cola? I know it's going through your head. I'm sorry. The Coke Zero is so good, and it helps me not drink regular soda. Probably will get dementia here in like 2 years because there was a link. I don't know if you heard about that. But the aspartame in this is being linked to dementia. So anyways, looks like I have 2 years to kick it with you guys. Siri, did I say, hey, Siri? Did I ever say, hey, Siri? I did there. Why don't you be quiet, man? Look at this thing.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Why do you keep talking? Leave me alone, dude. It's probably the FBI messing with me right now. Anyways, so my house got raided. Everything turned upside down. And, got met by 6 agents when I got off the plane. And they questioned me, said what was I doing in D.C.? Because there was pictures all over on Twitter of me in the Capitol. And they thought I was dangerous enough to come here with 14 agents point guns at my 13-year-old daughter at the time. Pointed guns at her. 15 agents closed off my road. And to this day, haven't been charged or arrested. Knock on wood. But let me just tell you something. It's the hardest time of my life, man. But next time I go here, I wonder if they're going to let me in the front doors with a pass. I wonder if they have me on that. Because every time I fly now, I'm marked as a domestic terrorist, just like all you school board parents. But every time I fly, I have to get completely strip searched. Like, I have to get patted down. I have to get, you know, they have to get all up inside me and all knee deep inside of me. And then they have to empty out all my luggage. Like, I have to go. I'm like at the highest security thing. Like, I'm like Osama bin Laden's family. Well, maybe not. Maybe higher than that because they were outside of 9/11, outside of the United States on 9/11 by the Bush family. But anyways, it's a different story for a different day. I wonder if I try to get a pass and I try to go in there. Next time I go there, I'm going to try that. But let's get back to it. 971-447-2555 if you want to call in. No really plan for this show. We're just going to go with it. We're going to go with the flow. Probably play a video game or two to end the stream. But I'm having a great time. I hope you guys are. Call in. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about some things. Was I muted the whole time in the Capitol right there? If you're in the chat, can you tell me if I was muted? If I was, hey, man, it's the first show. Give me a break. Hey, call in. I think someone already called in while we were, yeah, my bad. Someone called in. Let's see who it was. Someone texted me on my phone, too. What are we doing? Someone texted me. Well, it's Alan Drank from Ron Tonkin. Texted me a link. I don't know if you can see that. Let me see if it can. There we go. Text me a link. I might go get that Jeep in a week or so. We'll see how. Turn the freaking mic down. Gosh, I gotta remember that. Gotta remember to turn my mic down when I come back because it's on high when I'm at the Capitol. Anyways, let's check the Twitter feed. Let's see what's going on Twitter, huh? If you don't have Twitter. Or X now, Andy No, by the way, today, shouted me out. Feel really special. Andy No, you're a good man. Appreciate you. Sorry that you got you got Fetty whopped in the face by a milkshake, man. That's it's just must have been horrible for you. And we're with you, man. Doing some good stuff over there at Post Millennial. Yeah, he gave me a shout out. He played the clip we had here of the mom of the Hazelbrook girl.
And I really appreciate that. Thank you, Andy. Let's see. Let's go here. Let's go. Okay. It's gotten worse. People react to Monday's mass overdose. I wonder what you guys want to see? You guys want to see what they said? Let's see what they said. Hopefully you don't have to pay for this garbage. Fox 12 is garbage. Fox News is garbage too. Let's watch this. Let's see what people said in Portland about the latest overdose that's been happening for years. Let's pass
You've
another.
You got the look. Now, get the tickets.
This is so loud. Let's pass another law legalizing drugs, huh, Portland? By the way, this Saturday, and I'm only going to, you know, I'm going to give you guys a sneak peek at some of our, hold on, let's watch this real quick. I'm going to tell you what we're doing Saturday.
At the scene tell us this was the highest number of overdoses they've seen on a single call. Fox 12's Chandler Watkins spoke to
working,
several
huh?
people at the park in Northwest Portland where it happened and has the story tonight.
So what happened was unfortunate.
A woman experiencing homelessness we spoke to in North Park Blocks Tuesday afternoon didn't want to be identified, but did have something to say to those who helped eight people who overdosed in the park.
Jeez,
Monday morning.
Dude. All
people.
On Monday morning?
Some people do care. They carried up to a measured Narcan and time of need.
Yeah, you know who doesn't care, lady? Your city council and all the politicians that you guys keep voting in every cycle. That's who really doesn't care.
She wanted to thank first responders, as well as a bystander who administered Narcan to one person before crews got there.
Thank you for doing that, because life could have been lost. Because people care, those people didn't die.
Portland first responders say the call came in around 10:15 Monday morning, where eight people overdosed around the same time in the park. Officials believe the drug they took was laced with fentanyl.
The fact that there were eight overdoses yesterday was horrific and yet completely understandable.
They're going to keep saying this, though, until you guys start voting in new people.
With these narcotics coming in, you might think you're buying one thing and you're getting another, but the common denominator in all of it that is killing people is fentanyl.
He's seen the effects of the drug crisis.
Over the course of the last 2 years, I have personally at my office found three bodies gone.
If you have thoughts on this, call in.
He's calling on city and county leaders to do more to combat the growing problem in Portland.
I want to know why Multnomah County and the city of Portland and the joint office isn't releasing as much money as possible towards personnel on the streets that could help solve this. Because I can tell you, they're not. Nothing has changed in the last 4 years since I've been here. In fact, it's even gotten worse.
Reporting in downtown Portland.
But we keep voting for him, huh? Yeah, it's gotten worse, buddy, because you guys, I mean, this guy probably voted for the same people, too, that keep giving him empty promises. Oh, we're going to change things. We're going to, I mean, oh, my gosh, man. Did you hear the news, by the way? The local news is so fake, man. Wait, like, watch these people. Watch these people. Go watch Channel 8 or Channel 6 or Channel 2 if you can stomach it. Go watch it tonight at 11 o'clock or whenever it comes on. And I want you to see, like, did you see anything in there that said anything about Measure 110 or anything about making legal drug, you know, that making drugs legal? Did you see anything about, like, defunding police? Like, did you see anything? Did they call out the city leadership at all? No. They're just reporting on the drug crisis. And, oh, by the way, people shooting each other in Portland is gun violence. We're just going to chalk that up to gun violence. Oh, my gosh, man. It's disgusting. It's disgusting. It's sad because Portland used to be such a great city. I loved going to Blazer games when I was a kid in the 90s. It was just, used to be a great city, man. And the Democrats have ruined it, unfortunately. Let's see what else we got here. Hey, if you're from Portland, you guys want to call in, let's talk about it. 971, what's the number? 447-2555. Give me a call. Let's talk about it. Let's see. Help settle a very silly dispute. What are bears known for eating? Is this like a riddle? We're going to reply to it. People in sleeping bags. Nice. Are the best soft tacos of the bear world. That's pretty dark. John, give me a sec here. What are bears known? Why is this playing? Get out of me. Hold on one sec. Hey, John, you're on the air. Give me a sec. Helps settle of. Okay, so what are bears known for eating? I'm stumped. And that's going to be our reply. Very thought, well thought out reply. All right, let's go to John. He's calling. I don't know where he's calling from. Let's see. John, you're on the air. What, where are you calling from, buddy?
Yeah, so I'm on 26 right now, making my way back to Tigard. And I got off of work, put on your video, and yeah, honestly, it's the one thing that I really wanted to talk about was, you know, I noticed this phenomenon more so in the last 3 years than at any other time, is people's willingness to desensitize themselves to really what's going on in Portland, where I hear, you know, we've all heard the same thing. Oh, well, it's bad in every city, or, you know, oh, it's, things are going to get better, or, oh, I don't really go there anymore. I don't really know what's going on in Portland. And, like, there's almost this, like, willingness of the people that live in this area. I try to talk to everybody that I can. I do Lyft on the side, so I get random people in my car who will chew my ear off. And, yeah, it's either one side where they're like, no, the problems are real, and the people know exactly where the problems are coming from, or they're just willfully ignorant. And I don't know, maybe that's the culture of this area, but I don't really know. My question is, how do we flip this around so people can actually start caring? Because there's something that I tell people from the East Coast that they don't necessarily understand, but people in Portland will surely understand it, where someone will care more about a dog safety and they'll walk over a homeless person ODing in the street to go take care of a dog, right? Like, people in Portland care more about their dogs than they actually do human beings. And they'll vote for measures that are inherently against humanity, against people's human dignity. I mean, yeah. You were talking about...
What part of Highway 26 are you on right now, man?
So I'm getting off here. My next exit is on 216. So I'm a few exits away from Portland, but I'm heading towards Tigard right now.
217 or 216?
217. Sorry.
I was like, I don't think there's a 216. Yeah. So we're looking at a map right now. I'm looking at just where you are. I don't know. It's just fascinating to me. But anyways, yeah, man, you're absolutely right. I mean, you asked what do we have to do, you know, to solve this and to get people to wake up. I think a lot of people, I've seen more people awake today in Portland than ever before. The problem is that those people, just for being awake, doesn't necessarily that means that's going to translate to votes. Because I've seen a lot of, I mean, I worked on campaigns around here, man. I see how they are. People like to complain. They like to say, oh, I'm awake now. But then when it comes time to vote, they either don't vote or they go MIA. They don't want to volunteer for campaigns. And, you know, it's sad. It's sad, man. But I'll just say, I mean, we're going to find out why people vote this way. We're doing that on Saturday, actually. I was going to announce that here pretty soon. I'm going to announce it to you and to all the other viewers. We are going to Portland this Saturday to do some on-street content. We're going to ask people, just plan out, why do you still vote Democrat? And we're going to see what they say. So hopefully I'll have some better answers for you then. But do you, what part of Oregon are you from?
So I'm not from Oregon originally. I moved from the East Coast. So I spent about 5 years in D.C.
Oh, gosh.
And yeah, and I lived there during the Trump years. So it was actually a lot of fun to watch all the Trump derangement syndrome going on.
did you witness that actual insurrection and attack against our republic that happened on the night that he got elected?
Well, the night that he got elected, yeah, I was there for that. I was actually at the White House that night, and that was one of the funniest moments I'd ever seen, because you've got, imagine three groups of people. The first group is the journalists. The second group is the people celebrating the saving of our republic. And then the third group is all the people crying the end of our democracy, right? And it's just like, it's so crazy to just have that many different perspectives in one place.
Thousands of protesters also.
At such a significant place. So, yeah, I was there for inauguration. I went to the Women's March. I watched women assault a guy who was pretty well known around that area. He was, you know, one of those guys that carries up the signs telling you to repent.
Yeah.
And give your life to Jesus. And they full on assaulted the guy. And I was like 20 yards away out. And yeah, I full on witnessed it. And I never heard any reporting. I never heard any stories about it. And
we have, we're playing a video right now of the scene from that night, from the Trump inauguration back in 2017. We're looking at all kinds of violence, cars being, a limo being set on fire. You have Mayor Bowser here of DC. I mean, how bad is she? But check this out. I mean, I don't know if you're looking at the stream, but we have the, I mean, look at everything that's going on here. This all looked worse. And this is just a little fraction of everything that happened. You know, you guys didn't see the attack on the White House when they injured, when they actually injured multiple Secret Service agents.
I remember that night.
Yeah,
that
I mean, this is just a, this is just a fraction, but you never saw the outrage that you saw on that, that you've seen from January 6th. It's incredible.
Well, yeah, do people even remember the date of that day that they attacked the White House and Trump got put into the bunker? Like,
seriously.
I can't even remember.
Remember when they were making fun of him for going into the bunker?
Yeah, what were they calling him, Bunker Boy and all that? And
right.
Meanwhile, the, one of the oldest churches in the country across the street in Lafayette Plaza almost got burnt down. And how were the protesters rewarded? And if you go back, you can actually notice this on the timeline. If you go back and look, about a week and a half later, those protesters and rioters were rewarded by getting 16th Avenue renamed Black Lives Matter Avenue. And it's like, and I worked right down the street. I used to go on my lunch breaks and talk to the people on the street there. And
what did you do there?
You know, I worked with kids with autism. And so we had a little clinic right by Duke. And you know, whenever I had a lunch break, I'd go down. I like politics, so I'd go down and talk with them and see how, and just see what was going on there. And for the most part, I mean, you, when you run into people, when things are calm and things are fine and people are just living their lives, you know, you can have great conversations. But I was out when some of the, cause a lot of people forget, we had 8 o'clock curfews at that time in DC for two reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Reason number one was COVID, and reason number two was the rioting.
Mm.
And so you had to be in your house or your residency by 8 o'clock every night during that little stretch, the George Floyd stretch of COVID. And yeah, I remember I'd watch like a clip on my phone and it would be some kid graffitiing something. And I'd be like, wow, I drive by that statue, you know, every day on my way to work.
Yeah.
And then the next day I see two, you know, middle-aged black gentlemen who are clearly the cleaning crew scrubbing off, you know, fuck the police and all that. Or sorry, I know you're live. That's my bad.
You're okay, man. You're okay. It's okay.
But yeah, so that was, that, for me, that like, to live and to see that and then to turn around and say, oh, well, you know, we need to have empathy for this movement. And it's like, no, you know, there's been tons of movements that have pushed great ideas and they did so peacefully. And,
yeah.
And we're a country that you can still do that in. And it makes me so sad that the narrative gets so hell-bent on what are Republicans doing. And
yeah.
I wanted to ask you this too, because we were talking before about solving the problems of Portland. And I don't know if you watched Tim Pool at all, but his solution just for the country as a whole is to build a counterculture to the establishment culture that we have. And I really wonder, like, you know, for the Republican Party in Oregon, it's tough because you're in rural areas, you're spread out, you know, there's groundwork to be done in the suburbs, the urban area, it's a real big struggle.
Yeah.
But what could we be doing to kind of build the culture so it's not come for politics, but it's come for this event and, you know, oh, we're all talking, we're all having a good time, but we're all talking about the ideas that really matter that we want to be talking about. And then that kind of builds a subculture where a political movement can kind of be born out of that.
Yeah.
I know that's way easier said than done, but.
Right. Well, there's already great groups here in Oregon that exist in Oregon. You know, you got Carrie McQuiston that runs, you know, a group over there of what she's doing. You have Oregon Women for Trump, led by Carol Leak. You have a bunch of really good grassroots groups, man. And I'm just telling you, since you asked, I didn't want to get super negative tonight, but we're just going to, for the sake of truth and facts.
Let's hear it.
Until we have a strong Republican Party here in Oregon, nothing is going to change, in my opinion. That doesn't mean to lose faith. It doesn't mean to stop voting. That just means that, look, man, we have a bunch of like Kevin McCarthy's and we have a bunch of Mitch McConnell's here in Oregon that are just playing it super safe and they just are too afraid. They're terrified to fight back against the craziness that's going on. Now, we do have a couple good ones. We have Ed Deal. He's a representative. He just made the caucus leadership team in Salem. We have some good, we have a few good representatives in Oregon, but they're not, you know, part of the bigger leadership team. Like they don't have like a lot of pull when it comes to, but basically the Oregon Republicans, man, they're weak and ineffective. And you saw it when Christine Drazen ran for governor It was just like, what is, like, the number one question I was getting was, what is her message? What is she saying? Like, she just doesn't have anything. She's not, like, differing herself. She's not going hard enough. And it was just an aw shucks kind of campaign. And it's exactly what the Republicans are here in Oregon, how they started the walkout, which was great. I was talking to Tim Canope's son, I think his chief of staff, I think he is, Reagan Canope on X. And me and the guy, we've gone back and forth before. We don't really care for each other. But I was like, hey, man, I want to give credit where credit's due. Thank you for walking out for parents' rights. I hope you guys keep it up. We were supposed to have coffee. We were supposed to talk about how I could help him. And then they ended the walkout. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah. And they got nothing. Yeah. They got almost nothing done. He might as well have just not walked out at all. Because as a parent of a 15-year-old right now, if my kid wants to go transition, she can go do it without notifying me. She can go get an abortion without notifying me. And so what did we really walk out for? So, man, I just will tell you, John, I'll just tell you, man, until we have a strong, and it doesn't mean we need to go super extreme far right MAGA. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that we have to have fighters here in Oregon that aren't afraid. And you had the leverage with this walkout and you folded. You folded like you always do. You folded on gun rights. You folded on parents' rights. And then you come out and you have the gall to say that you saved parents' rights. So, John, good people like you and good people that watch this show and that follow us. And if we just keep doing what we're doing, keep speaking up, keep trying to keep the faith, man, I think we can really make some headway. And but at the end of the day, till we have a strong Republican Party who's not afraid of the Democrats, they're like Democrat lights. Nothing's going to change. We should have won the governor's race in 2022. I mean, every Democrat I've talked to said that they were 100, even Representative Travis Nelson, the chief sponsor of House Bill 2002, said that he was almost certain that Drazen was going to win, and we didn't. And it was because she ran a bad campaign, and Betsy Johnson took a lot of the GOP voters, because that's another thing. They don't have... The GOP here in Oregon, the politicians here in Oregon, the GOP politicians are disconnected with the grassroots. I think they can't stand the grassroots. We're the grassroots. I'm the grassroots. They can't stand us. They see us as a thorn in their side. I wish that wasn't the case. And maybe if some of them are listening, maybe they can come on and set the record straight. But John, appreciate the call, dude. And that was good stuff. And I'm glad that you escaped Washington, D.C., but you also came to kind of a worse place. So,
going to Florida next, brother. Have a great rest of your night.
Hey, you too, sir. Thank you. That's John from Boston, Massachusetts. I don't know if he's from Boston. I just wanted to say Boston. It says Massachusetts on the caller ID. But he's from the East Coast, used to live in Washington, D.C., and that was a good call. Appreciate that call, man. 971-447-2555. Let's go back to the Twitter feed. Let's see what else is going on here tonight. Let me see here. Let's go home. Oh, hold on. We got something 20 hours ago. Arrest made in Snapchat bomb. Wait, I didn't hear about this. What? The arrest was made in a Snapchat bomb threat to Hazelbrook Middle School 20 hours ago. So that was yesterday at 9 p.m. No way. So they caught the person who made the threat. This is the first I'm finding out about this. This is actually incredible. So if you don't know, there was a bomb threat made to Hazelbrook Middle School after the kid was attacked. The mother was here, remember? That girl that was attacked, that video that we saw earlier in the show. Wow, I did not know this. How did I not know this? Well, I have been off the news cycle today. Evacuated due to bomb threat, went viral. Okay, blah, blah, blah. I wonder if it's literally someone from the left. On September 28th, threatening messages of violence targeting students and staff were made on Snapchat. On the morning of September 29th, another threat was emailed to the school, triggering the evacuation. In a joint blah, 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 they revealed that an arrest was made in connection to the Snapchat threat and that the Washington County Juvenile Department received a law enforcement referral. A petition filed with the juvenile court lists charges for disorderly conduct and telephone harassments. How about now, like, terrorist charges because you made a bomb threat? The youth alleged to be responsible for social media threat has been arrested by the Tualatin Police Department. I'm going to do some digging on this, and we are going to find out. We're not going to post. We're not going to dox this youth. That's not what I'm saying. Calm down, YouTube. We are going to figure out who this kid is. And if he turns out, and like I said, we're going to be real. I'm going to be real. I'm not out here trying to play partisan politics. I'm not out here trying to I just like to tell truth. So if it turned out to be a conservative or a Trump supporting student, we're going to call for that student to be held as accountable just as much as I guarantee you it's not that person. It's not a person like that. But I'm going to do some digging. We're going to find out. We're going to find this out. I love being back because I can actually dig into this stuff and we can figure this out together. But look at this. So it was a juvenile that did it. Due to the Oregon law, privacy of teens, we can't release any identity. In a statement, blah, 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 while we disclose the current status of the youth responsible for the threat in terms of enrollment, we assure students and parents that the measures have been implemented to ensure their safety at Hazelbrook Middle School. Oh, really? Okay, so now you're going to worry about safety. Okay, unless you're a certain kind of kid, then you can just beat the hell out of all these girls. Sorry, parents. Sometimes I'm going to cuss, and it's just how it is. I'm not going to say any bad, really bad words. Sometimes they'll slip out, and I apologize, okay? Going to try to keep it family-friendly. Let's calm down. Oh, this Coke Zero is making me really cranky because it's making me hungry. Let's see. District officials clarify. Okay, we're going to find out. We're going to find out, guys. This is that's pretty crazy that they found the person. Wow. Well, actually, let's put out a tweet right now. Let's just say, hey. If anyone knows details about this kid who made the threats, please share. Don't share the kid's identity or put him in. We got to put this disclaimer because, you know, they're already looking at us as right-wing terrorists. We got don't share the kid's identity or put him or put his safety in jeopardy. I'm like typing so slow right now. But it would be really interesting to see why the threats were made. And we're going to be bold here, and we're going to be bold. I'm going to say, I guarantee, because I always have to put my opinion in there. I guarantee it wasn't a conservative student. Post that. Boom. You guys are seeing live tweets right now. You're seeing how it's done. I usually do them on my phone. Gentry Javers. He's a guy. He's a really cool guy up in Seattle. He does a lot of content up there. I just got blocked from commenting on Instagram because I called someone retarded. Please, plot twist, they called me. Okay. Gentry, we're trying to be examples of Christ, bro. Can't be going out around using the R word. Okay? Only in behind the scenes with your bros. Never online. This is a good account to follow right here. She's awesome. She's a Russian friend of mine. And you can already hear the people say, oh, he's got Russian friends that are from Russia that are pro-Putin. Oh, he must be a terrorist. She's really cool. Christian. WTF Portland. Good account there, too. Crazy videos on there. ChatGPT cheat sheet. I'm going to bookmark that one. Let's bookmark that one. How do you bookmark it? Oh, that's an ad? Okay, no, we're not interested. Never mind. You know what? We are actually going to... Tell X that we are not interested in this. Why this ad? Report ad. Something else. Yeah, I don't want to see ads like that. Like, let's be real about it. I don't want to see ads. There's Representative Congresswoman Lori Chavez DeRemer. Still waiting for my, and this is a true story, Lori Chavez. I'm still waiting for my my royalties because you stole this design from me. She's from Happy Valley, and I ran a campaign last year for Happy Valley City Council candidate. And I kid you not, I designed his logo. I got to show you guys it. This is actually kind of funny. You guys, I mean, like I said, I'm talking, whatever, dude. Like, I don't care. Lori, like, I love Lori. I'm not happy with how she's like so like about McCarthy, but I do like her. She's a great person. I wish she'd stop playing party politics, though. She actually, when I had a question, I called her chief of staff, and I was like, I'm really concerned about this when the primaries were happening. And she called me on my personal phone, and she was like, hey, what questions can I answer for you? I really appreciated that, man. I really appreciate that. It was about abortion. Let's see. I'm going to show you guys. This is hilarious. You tell me she did. They didn't take the, and I'm flattered. Trust me. I'm not complaining. I'm not getting all butthurt. I'm flattered. I'm flattered that they used, that I inspired their logo. All right. Where is it at? Let me look here. You guys are seeing all my files, dude. Oh, here we go. Check this out. So where'd it go? No. Where'd it go? It was almost, okay. I'm almost there. Almost there, I promise. Hold on. Calm down. Okay, check this out. So this was the logo I designed for my candidate. Ah, shoot. You can't really. It's PNG. We don't want PNG. We want this one. No, we don't want that one either. Can you just give us a clean logo? There we go. Check that out. Okay. Look at this logo. Oh, I love you guys. I love it. I'm laughing because I love that. You know, I haven't said this. This is actually the first time I'm like saying this. I said this to a couple buddies. But look at this. I designed this, and then Lori Chavez, look at them side by side. Tell me that's not the same logo. Okay? You got the mountains. It's literally the same font too. And then you got the square with the position, right? Tell me right now, because they created theirs after us, so we had this first. That's awesome. I love that, man. I love it. That's what I love about marketing, man. I love that I can look at that, and maybe they didn't. Maybe there's a chance that they just like thought the same way that their marketing team or their whatever graphic designer that they hired to do that. Maybe they came up with the same idea. What do you guys think? Anyways, love that. Lori, let's figure it out. I love you. Participants in my, okay, until then, I still support her, okay? She's pretty, meet her in person. She's a pretty, pretty real person. Keeps it real. Oh, gosh. Got Carrot Top here. What is she talking about?
No barriers. Here's what I can say. I can speak to what the president was very clear in saying, and also what you all have been reporting about.
Now they want a wall.
About this this construction. So the facts are this. This is not new. These funds were appropriated in fiscal year 2019 under Republican leadership, and DHS is required by law to use the funds for appropriated purpose. That's what we're seeing. This was announced back in June by the DHS. And so, look, we believe that there are better effective ways of moving forward to secure our border.
It's a bunch of word salad.
Our border security.
In other words, Trump was right, and we're building the wall that he said we should. Remember the wall, the racist wall? Now all of a sudden they're wanting, I don't know if you guys saw that story, but they're wanting to build the wall now. Oh my gosh. This is a great account to follow, by the way, if you don't follow her. Great account right here. Gia Makul. She has a lot of really good tweets and a lot of really good relationship advice, marriage advice, really. And she's like super in shape too. Look at this chick. No, that's not her. We're not in Portland. She's like really in shape, man. It's like literally I feel attacked every time she posts a fitness pic. I mean, what are we doing? Well, that's her. And she's married. She's got a great husband, it sounds like. Anyways, moving on. Laura Loomer, true story again. Ordered a shirt from you, Laura Loomer, like 35 days ago, and I still have yet to get it. You charged me. It's on my statement. You charged me. But I have yet to get the shirt. It's the one that says, Donald Trump did nothing wrong. Still haven't gotten the shirt. 971. 447-2555. Give the show a call, man. We've had some great calls for the show. I'm really, really happy with some of the calls. You guys, love hearing from you guys, man. It's good stuff. Lars Larson, man, this guy's a jerk to me. I love Lars. He's like literally one of the first conservative voices I listen to. I'm going to tell you another inside story right now, true story, okay? This guy, you won't believe what this guy did to me, okay? I don't think he knows how much I like him, like how much I like see him as like one of my heroes, one of my inspirations. I mean, he was one of the first voices I listened to on the radio over, you know, 12 to 15 years ago, along with Glenn Beck. They were one of the first conservative voices I listened to on the radio. But Lars, like, I love Lars, man. I can never get mad at him. He can do no wrong. He is my spirit animal. But let me tell you what he did to me, man. This guy snaked me. This guy right here. This guy right here snaked me, bro. So we had a podcast used to be called The Bold-Faced Truth, right? And now it's called The Cold Hard Truth. There's a reason for that. I don't know if you guys caught on to that. There's a reason for that. This guy, Lars Larson, contacted his friend, John Canzano. He's a sports columnist. He used to be a sports columnist for the Oregonian here. John Canzano, he has a show on 750 The Game. Really well-known guy in sports. He's a great writer. Have a lot of respect for him. Well, this guy, Lars, I invited Lars onto the podcast, and he was like, hey, man, I don't really have time. And I was like, oh, okay, well, check out our podcast and, you know, in case you change your mind down the road. And I get an email from John Canzano that says, oh, hey, man, my friend Lars told me that you have a show that's pretty close to the name of my show. And I need you to change the name of your show. And if you don't, I'm going to have my attorneys. This is John Canzano. He said, I'm going to have my attorneys send you a cease and desist if you don't change the name of your podcast from Bald Faced Truth. His podcast name is Bald Faced Truth because he's bald. It's Bald Faced Truth. First of all, I had my legal person look up the name and see if it was trademarked. It wasn't. The trademark ended like 2 years ago, so he had absolutely no legal right to that name. And second of all, I'm pretty sure that wasn't trademark infringement because it's Bold-Faced Truth. It's a pretty common saying, right? So I said, look, man, hey, John, I need you to calm down for a sec. And out of respect to you, I'm going to change the name of the podcast. And we're not going to be called both. We're going to be called Cold Hard Truth. Are you okay with that? He was okay with it. And, you know, I could have gone down the road of like, hey, you don't own the trademark anymore. And then this other thing is like this guy, Lars Larson, man, this guy right here, this guy snaked me. Who does that? I invited him onto a podcast and then he turns around and tries to rat us out. I mean, I wasn't doing anything, you know, malicious with it. I just, Bold-Faced Truth, it sounded great. It sounded like kind of something we want to do, you know? But anyways, that's my Lars Larson story. Talked to him on the phone yesterday and exchanged messages with him. Pretty dry to me, pretty mean. It's unfortunate because I love him. He could slap me in the face, I'd still love him. But yeah, he's probably got a lot on his mind. It's kind of like meeting your hero and then your hero kind of looks at you and is like, get away from me, kid. You know, that's how I kind of felt. Anyways, moving on. I'm having such a good time on this show, man. I hope you guys are too. Tell your friends about the show. Tell people about this show, man, before it gets taken off of YouTube, because it's going to get taken off. It's going on Rumble too. Like, I'm posting it to Rumble. But tell people about this show, man. Like, let's not lose our minds, right? Come to the show. Let's hang out every week. I don't know what days I'll be streaming because I don't know the schedule of my week. So it'll just be when I can, but it will be every week, I promise, because this is too fun. This is too fun not to do. But tell your friends about this, man. Send this to a friend. Say, hey, you need to watch this stream. And tell them you're not going to be their friend if they don't. You think I'm kidding? I'm not trying to crack a joke. Like, really tell them that. Because we're just getting started, man. We got a lot of stuff. I wish I could tell you guys some of the things that we're trying to do. I don't want you to get your hopes up like the interview. See how that went. Let's look at the Twitter. What else is going on? See, by now, my eyes and my mind would be like with these all these lights in here, I would be like, I couldn't do it. So these glasses are allowing me to go longer, and also giving a nod to my. How long have we been live for? 1 hour and 30 minutes. Wow, it doesn't even feel time flies, huh? Suspended Oasis, first person charge on the new organ. I don't want to read that. What is this? What else we got going on? Kamala Harris. Oh gosh. Can you guys stomach real quick these screeching imbeciles from The View?
I will just say about Jim Jordan, you know, he has been called by his own party, by John Boehner, a political terrorist. He's also been linked to the Ohio State sexual abuse scandal. I testified in front of Congress about something so simple, cameras in courtrooms. He